Alright, today I have an interesting topic for you guys in order to understand the role of institutions in the crypto market, alright? So watch through the end and you will learn about how institutional players operate, alright? So back in September 2019, I had the opportunity to come to the office of Winter Capital in Stockholm and have a sit down with Marco Poblete, the head of legal there, to talk a bit about, you know, the startup company and the sort of broader market in general. So let me just get into it, and after reading this article you will have a bit more understanding on how institutions operate in the crypto market. Alright, so stick with me to the end, let's do this. So first, Winter Capital, it has some heavy names on the investor list such as Christian Ander, an early Bitcoin billionaire. And just to introduce the company, Winter Capital is a startup company that collects and analyzes financial data regarding cryptocurrencies, making information available about the value of cryptocurrencies in the form of an index, you know, just like the S&P 500. So you can have a crypto index as well with, you know, Bitcoin, Ethereum, Doge, etc. All right. Why is this essential? Well, providing a crypto index is essential in order for large institutional players, right? This is your Citis, your Morgan Stanley's, those who provide financial instruments, right? To be able to create products that correlate with the value of cryptocurrencies, the data is delivered by Winter Capital, is the mathematical explanation behind why a certain product following the value of crypto moves the way it does in terms of market value. So in order to actually make a tradable sort of certificate, you know, like an ETF or something like this, these financial institutions, they need the data, all right? Why is this from a legal standpoint? So following the European benchmark regulation, a third-party index provider is needed to prevent market manipulation. An independent data provider ensures a healthy financial market. And I have provided a link to the Winter 5 index here. So I will leave this down in the description if you want to look at who's on the index. And this is a picture of the Winter Capital team, those who work there at this time. All right, so what does success look like for a startup such as Winter Capital? They defined it as making cryptocurrencies a natural part of the traditional financial market by being regulated and providing compliance for issuers. Winter Capital can assure that large institutions are able, from a risk and regulations perspective, oh, that's a word for you, to invest in cryptocurrencies. By bringing more liquidity to the crypto market, it will mature the sector and make crypto a more viable and less volatile digital asset. So a bit complex word in there. Marco is head of legal, so he has some broad vocabulary. And basically what this means is that in order for cryptocurrencies to be more sort of easy to trade, more accepted, they need this type of regulation in the back. So this process is happening with the indexes just to make, you know, crypto trading easier for large institutions. And if we look forward to today, you can see, for example, Goldman Sachs talking about it, and even on such, you know, Swedish platforms like Nordnet, you can invest in different financial products. So a lot has happened since 2019 in this market. But this is sort of the trend on the regulation side, on where the market is moving, if that makes sense to you. Alright, so what's the biggest risk to a startup like Winter Capital? So on that question, Marco answered that cryptocurrencies and blockchain has not even been around for 10 years yet, which makes it difficult to predict the future of the technology. There is also a threat to the market from stable coins, such as, you know, the Libra, the one that Facebook was talking about, that aspires to dominate the market of digital payments. Libra sees an issue with more democratic cryptocurrencies, such as Bitcoin, and instead they peg their digital asset to fiat, you know, the dollar, the greenback, the Swedish krona, etc. We see a value in a market with a democratic monetary policy. With decentralized blockchain technology, this is a possibility. Alright, so I'm not gonna... I mean, if you watch my channel, you already know what monetary policy is and sort of generally how you regulate it. I see my demographic is very much on the older side. So I'm not gonna go more into that. Just continue on with the article. So what inspired Marco to fully commit to Winter Capital? It was clear to him that Winter could fill an essential and valuable function in the financial market. The demand for more mature, structured product based on digital assets, such as crypto, was there, but key players were missing in the field. A stable and regulated crypto index provider was one of those key players previously missing. Winter was founded in the midst of crypto winter. The value of the largest currency, Bitcoin, was down to $3,000. Those were the times, and the general sentiment was that cryptocurrencies was something that happened in 2017. Yeah, those were the times. We strongly believe in blockchain technology and in the potential of cryptocurrencies. The rationale behind making cryptocurrencies market indexes is to not bet on a single coin, but to believe in the future value of the cryptocurrency market as a whole. So essentially something for investors who want to diversify a bit more, who maybe not read up so much on single cryptos. We can see some of them are mooning right now and others are dropping off after an initial coin offering. But with the index, it's possible to diversify a bit more. And this is something that we haven't really seen on the market yet. A broader index for multiple cryptocurrencies, at least not yet in Sweden. We only have indexes for the big ones, so to say. Right, so what was the most critical project for Winter Capital right now, and how did they plan to achieve it? Now, this was back in 2019. And the most critical project then was an application to basically the Swedish SEC to become a registered index administrator. With a valid registration, we can see and do business in all of the European Union. Public investments are not only private, can be made in products following our Winter 5 index. I've been working hard with the paperwork while we sent in some for some weeks from now. The paperwork is extensive and I'm grateful for the legal advice we've had from our law firm. Before I left the office of Winter Capital, we talked more about the investors behind the company. So apparently many of them had invested in Bitcoin. Yeah, this was an interesting discussion. I'm not going to go into it more on this video, but a lot of money was invested back then and still is. So what can you learn from this article, basically just to summarize it? We've seen financial instruments tracking larger cryptocurrencies, but behind the scenes there's also work to create more like an index fund in cryptocurrencies. And this is something that I predict we will see in the market in the future. As you know, all this background legal work gets done, it always takes time with institutions. So I hope you like this new concept of me sort of presenting an interview. It's one of the goals I have, the long goals of this channel when it gets bigger, hopefully, is to do interviews with people that I'm familiar with that have gone out and done interesting careers, just to hear different perspectives on the markets in Africa and Asia, South America, the United States, and all those other interesting companies and markets that people that I used to study with have gone out and worked in. So maybe someday, but for now, thank you for watching and I hope you make a lot of money, friend. Take care, bye bye.